In this section, we're going to create the admin page that has information from the Windows system like time, date, CPU, RAM utilization, as well as hard drive space, and a button that calls the Windows calculator. And we're also going to add dynamic 2-hour stop RT button that will stop runtime. So let's get started. First, we're going to open Tag Management. In Tag Management, we're going to select the top layer in our tree, right click, and choose Add New Driver. And I am going to choose the System Info Driver. This is a Windows driver that allows me to get information from the PC, like the CPU, hard drive space, and the amount of available RAM. If we go to create a connection, we right click, and I can just call it PC. And there's no further configuration required. If I go to connection parameters, it just tells us that we don't have to do anything since it's connecting to the local system. Now let's create some tags under our system info channel. We'll do time. And it's going to be an 8-bit text, and our length is going to be 12. And then we just highlight the tag, and in our properties window, we'll choose the time function, and our minute second with AM or PM. Next, we will do date. It's also text with a length of 10. And the address will just be the date function. Next, we'll do CPU utilization. That's going to be a floating point. And we will just pull down CPU utilization. We'll do total load. We'll make our RAM tag. It's also going to be floating point. And then for our address, available main memory, and we'll do in percentage. And then finally, we have C hard drive. It'll also be floating point. We'll do drive space, free memory, and percent. Next, we will put these tags on our admin screen. So I'm going to take this text box and just kind of make it a heading. I'm just going to place it around here. And just put admin functions here. Now let's add these tags from the system info channel to our admin screen. First, I'll go to my tags browser and find my tags. Here they are. And I can use my shift key and just select all of these and pull them out, let them go. So it's created appropriate IO fields for all my tags. And we're going to want to do some static text labels. So I'll just make a label here, system information. I'll duplicate that and we'll just make labels for each of these. So the first one was time. I'll duplicate that. Date. And then I can lasso those, duplicate those, pull those down. And CPU. RAM. Looks like I'm going to have to move some stuff up a little bit. So I'll just grab these, pull them up, and then duplicate one more. And that is going to be my space. And then I can just kind of move this up, lasso all of these, do evenly space. Now I want to pull my IO fields down. So I'm just going to grab the first one, go to properties. See how this is bold? That tells me there's something there. This is my hard drive, so it's the bottom one. So I can just kind of pull this down. And I'll just kind of size it. And we'll just go ahead and pull all of these down and just kind of eyeball them. Now time and date are strings, so I'll just make these kind of fill in that space there. And I want them to be formatted somewhat like these. So these are also strings. So I am just going to copy the properties out of that using my eyedropper, paste it in, maybe give it a little bit different color. And then I can do the same thing with this. And if I want to use my shift key, I'll touch the first one, hold my shift key down, do the second one, and I can do make the same width. Now, I don't want to use cut and paste properties here because these are all numerical data types. And if I copied them from here, it would make them text. I'd have to go back and change it. So let's make one of these the same. And then we will copy it to the others. So for CPU, we're going to have a unit, which is these are all in percent. So I'll pull this out. And then I'm just going to duplicate this. Put a percent in there. And then we're going to need that for the others. So I'll just go ahead and put those there. And then for our font, make that 26. And then we don't need the sign for these. I don't think you can have negative CPU. And let's make that centered. And then we'll also use this same color here. And you'll notice nothing changed, so that means our global color scheme is on. And then now I can just copy the properties out of that, hold my shift key down, paste them in there. And then let's use our alignment tools. I will once again select this one as my reference. Make them the same size. Go ahead and just make sure they're aligned left. And then I'm going to save this. Let's do one other thing. Let's change all the font colors to white. Now I'm going to show you another trick that's really cool. These are all IO fields. You probably know what Control A does. I'm just going to click here just to kind of clear the cursor, hit Control A. Notice that it highlights or it selects everything on the screen. Well, that's nothing new. Control A does that. But here's a trick in WinCC. Let's say I want to select all the IO fields. I can select an IO field, and if I hit Control A, it is going to select all objects of that exact same type. So that works with labels, it works with ActiveX controls, whatever. So that's something really nice if you just need to go change all of the same type of object to something. So now I'll just go to font color. I'll make it white and then save. And let's take a look at what this looks like in runtime. Got my main picture here open. I like to go to runtime on main because I have my buttons. We'll go to admin, and we've got a nice display here, time, date, and our system percentages. So going back to graphics designer, I think I'm just going to grab all of these objects and just kind of move them up. And then let's say that we want a button to call another application on the computer, say calculator. I'm just going to grab a button and just kind of pull it out. Here's my configuration. And here's my calculator. And then I'll make the font bigger. So let's say that when we press this button, we want to call the Windows calculator. Now, Windows comes with a calculator. It's called calc.exe. We can use a dynamic wizard to just launch that application. Now, of course, if you know scripting like C or VB, you could also use that. The dynamic wizard is so that you don't have to. So on dynamic wizard, I'm just going to open the toolbar, and then under system functions, we have start another application. So I'm just going to grab that, double click. This is the wizard, and it's going to ask me the dynamic. So I will just do left mouse key. And then it's going to ask me the application name. So here I can just go browse on the system, and calculator lives in Windows System 32, and there's calc.exe. So I'll just grab that and then finish. So we're going to save, and just to show you what happened, if we go to properties on the events of this button, you can see the mouse is now bold and there's a C action on it. So if we save this, we're going to leave our page and come back to refresh it, hit calculator, and there's our calculator. We can also use dynamic wizards to create our stop RT button. So on main screen, go to your stop RT button, go to dynamic wizard, and under system functions, we have exit WinCC runtime. So make sure that your button is highlighted. You can tell the stop RT button is highlighted because it's got the handles around it. We will double click, hit next. We'll select a dynamic, left mouse key, click next. And then it just says when you click the button with your left mouse key, it will stop runtime. So we'll just click finish. So if we save, and then we're just going to go to runtime there. Notice how when I mouse over, it's got the C icon on it. If I click that, it takes us right out of runtime. Later, we'll add some more features to our admin page.